Hello everyone, Alexander Flores here, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can call or invoke a Lambda function from within another Lambda function. So I have an empty folder here. I'm going to go ahead and make a new file called index.js, and we're going to go into our console, which is in this folder. We're going to run npm init-y. This will initialize our project. We're going to copy a start script from a previous video. This will be in the description so you can copy it. It'll also be found in the GitHub repository, which is linked in the description. We're going to paste this inside of our scripts here. This just simply allows us to run this as if it was a normal Lambda function. So now under our index, what we're going to want to do is we're going to create a main function, which will be an asynchronous function, which has an event parameter. And we're going to console log the event, and we're going to return an empty string for now. Exports.handler equals main. This way Lambda actually has access to this function. We're then going to want an add function, which will take num1 and num2. And we're going to add a simple to-do that says invoke the add function Lambda. So now we're going to want to import AWS. So AWS equals require AWS SDK. And in our console, we have to run npm install AWS SDK. We're also going to need to create a Lambda object. We can do that by saying Lambda equals new AWS.lambda with a capital L. And inside the constructor, we're going to have an object with a pass in a region. This region for me of where I'm hosting the Lambda functions will be US East 1. However, enter whatever region you're going to be adding your target Lambda function in. We're now going to save this, and we want to go over to the AWS console. We're going to minimize our console, and we're going to create a new Lambda function. This will simply be called add function, and we don't have to set up any permissions. We can just create the function. Once it's created, we're going to write a very simple function inside the editor. We're going to return event.num cast to an integer or a number plus event.num2. Actually, this should be event.num1. So this will simply just return num1 and num2 added together as numbers. Control S to save this and click save at the top here. Now to make sure this works, we're going to configure a test event. We can call this test. We're going to say num1 is going to be 5 and num2 is going to be 49. We can go ahead and create this, and we can run the test at the top right, and we see our result. So this function works. So we're going to let this be. We're going to go back to VS Code. And our goal is to actually add that using num1 and num2. So we're going to go into our package.json, and we're going to add in our parameters. Num1 will be 20. Num2 will be 30. I'm going to go ahead and save this. And also, the edited version that I just created here will also be in the description, so you can copy it. We're going to close that file. And now our main function is actually going to return add with event. Actually, we don't even need to cast that to a number. Event.num1 and event.num2. So the add function is going to return a new promise. So this has to become an asynchronous function. We're going to have resolve and reject, pretty standard stuff. And we're going to create a parameter object. This is going to hold some information. The first piece of information is the function name, which is add function. We get that from the actual Lambda function name, and it knows exactly the region to use because we specified the region in the constructor whenever we initialize Lambda. The second thing is going to be the payload, which is the information that is sent to the Lambda function. So to do this, we're going to stringify some JSON, and we're going to say num1 and num2. And this is going to return a callback once we actually invoke the Lambda function. So in order to do that, we're going to say lambda.invoke. We're going to pass in the parameters. And then our callback is going to have an error or results. And so we're going to say if there's an error, we're going to reject with the error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the results. So we can go ahead and save this. And if we look back, number 1 is 20, number 2 is 30. If we go into our console and we run npm run test, we get this object back here. We see that the payload is 50. So that's the results. So if we go back, whenever we resolve, we wanted to resolve results.payload. So we can save this, we run the code again, and now we get 50. Now currently it's a string, however, obviously you can change that, but this is how you would invoke a Lambda function from within another Lambda function. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.